What's up, Patrick?
Hey.
What's up,
come
dudes?
On in. We just
yeah, don't worry about it. Don't shake my hands.
I only do two hands. I'm so sorry.
That's okay. It's your policy.
Right?
I was going to give you come to bed eyes, but you're not going to get those.
Oh,
anymore.
My God. Hold on.
There it is. Now they're touching and hugging. This is great.
He went for no pat. He just did the full hug, too.
Yeah, this is nice.
Put now, a hand on his upper ass cheek.
I appreciate that. No, we're going to take our shirts off when we do it.
Let's do it.
When you, so like, you went through this run of being a huge child star. All like the kid sports movies, that was your shit.
Yeah, I like to say I was the go-to chubby kid. In the
yeah.
90s, you know what I mean? Yeah.
When you get older, and you look exactly the same as you did when you were a kid.
Yeah.
Is this a blessing or is it like, I really thought by the time I was at least maybe in my 30s, I'd be able to escape this and I cannot do this.
You know, I guess it's a blessing to the extent that, you know, I haven't aged that much.
Yeah.
So that's a good thing. It's
like, I'd put you in a pair of soccer shorts right now.
Right? Yeah. I wish, to be honest, I wish I could grow a beard. That's a bit unfortunate.
And you can just marry one instead.
I like the way he thinks. Yeah. How about you? That would be the one thing. That's the.
Why do you
want to
grow a beard? I hate facial hair. Like, I'm not very hairy and I hate when I get it.
Because here's the thing, I still have to shave. So if I didn't have to shave, okay, but like that's a powerful beard.
Thank
right
you
there.
Very much. I was thinking
it's
the same
awful.
Thing.
You said awful wrong.
It's yeah. real wild how you chose to do it the same length everywhere.
Yeah. Well, I thought that was important. By the way, in 1 week, the great Hambino and Stone Cold Steve Austin both complimented my beard. So basically, you could say whatever you want; doesn't matter anymore.
Yeah.
All right.
You know, this is Hall of Fame level.
That is true.
Yeah.
And I want to have a powerful Justin Turner red beard going on. You
yeah.
Because redheads with beards, there's something great about.
Oh it. Yeah.
Tormund from
Game of Thrones.
That's right.
From Game of Thrones. Yeah. That's a good beard.
Yeah. Redhead without
a
beard.
You look like a man. You look like a man. You look like a real man. It's like there's Andy Milonakis actually still looks like a child. He has that like
sure.
thing. Whereas you just look like a sweet boy, man. Do you know what I mean?
Thank you. For the Game of Thrones finale, I dressed up as Tormund.
Really?
You did?
Well, we did a little thing, and yeah, we all dressed up, and I was Tormund.
So they just announced Disney Plus. Like, everybody's super excited. It's the one new streaming service that people are actually excited about, because they're doing Hulu and Disney and ESPN. Yeah. It's like $12 or something like that. But they're doing a Sandlot series?
Yeah.
And they got all you guys back?
Except Benny, except Mike. Yeah, he's not going to do it.
Did he not want to?
He's a firefighter. The jerk, you know?
saving
the world.
Yeah. Isn't that funny, though? Sandlot fans would be like, what the fuck are we going to do without Benny? They're still pissed. It's not enough that he's a firefighter.
Yeah, exactly.
Is
the
dog back as well?
The dog passed, unfortunately.
Oh, thanks, Mike. Thanks a lot. Why don't we just watch a YouTube video about a girl and her dog?
Yeah. You brought you a real dark place there, Mike.
Those big dogs last about 12 years. And that, you know.
The beast is gone.
It was 11 and a half when you filmed.
Yeah, the beast. I know that movie, yeah.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
Yes. I remember that. Yeah, I do. Okay.
Yeah, the beast. He took the ball.
It just took me. Oh, yes.
Remember
what
James Earl Jones
Yep.
I don't know if you know. I don't know. Like, I'm sure that. People have done impressions of you.
Yeah.
People do impressions of Squint saying forever all the time.
Right.
But Jim Norton, he does the quintessential.
Well,
I mean, to me, it's quintessential. And
you.
I'm a huge fan of the film.
You've said that.
The quintessential James Earl Jones in the Sandlot impression.
Really?
Have you ever heard it before?
So no. What happens? So now what happens? You guys are trying to what?
Well, you're
trying to get the ball back.
Yes.
Yeah, and so you knock on the door.
Okay, yep.
And so I'll be, you know, me and we're knocking on the door and we open the door and there's James Earl Jones and we go, "Hey, what happened to our ball?"
"My dog has your ball."
I mean, come on.
Wow.
Hey, guys. We have it back?
No.
It's great.
Leave.
I don't know.
Your ball is mine.
I don't even know why they hired James Earl Jones. They should have just got you.
They probably paid him so much to do Mufasa in this new Lion King movie.
Unnecessary.
Waste of money.
Yeah. I could have just done it.
You would have done it for pennies on the
dollar.
Yeah,
you shot over someone's shoulder from the back and I just threw the voice.
You have.
That ball belongs to me.
I still have your ball.
I still have your ball.
Give me a second. I have chills. I'm sorry.
Well, then, can we have that ball that's signed by the rest of the team?
No.
Oh, jeez.
That belongs to me.
A meaner James. Yeah.
Just becomes a real bummer of a movie.
Get out of here, or I'll break your feet.
Dennis Leary comes back. He's just pissed. There's nothing to replace.
Dennis Leary?
Yeah, he played the stepdad.
Yeah, yeah.
It's his ball that the Beast took.
Yeah, I did not even remember that.
Yeah,
he
plays
the stepdad. Signed ball.
And then he gave him the murderer's row ball at the end.
Yep. Except in this version, he doesn't give him
anything. He breaks his leg.
They both belong to me.
This is bogus. I signed it before.
James Earl Jones, just a fake sports memorabilia dealer.
I forgot the murderer's row ball. Yeah, that was with Gehrig and him, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Babe Ruth.
What was it like for you in that era? Like, did you go to school or did you end up getting homeschooled?
I dropped out of junior high. That was it. No, I'm just
kidding. I'm a man with a sixth grade education.
I'm an elementary school dropout. That movie was filmed in the summer, so we were basically on summer vacation anyway.
Yeah, but when you get back to school and the whole world has seen it and is obsessed with it for the next 20 years.
Yeah, it was a little strange.
I would imagine it comes up from time to time.
Yeah, luckily I was in a K-8 private school, or K-12, excuse me, private school. So I had already gone to school for a few years and then I stayed there. So it wasn't quite as bad as just going to a new school after. Yeah.
Were there other child actors that didn't get their break yet? Pissed that you got the opportunity.
Completely. And I'll tell you, I was up for
other chubby kids that were far less charming.
Changing their hats to backwards.
I could do that.
I was in the school play and I had like the lead bad guy, and then I booked son-in-law, and I was like, sorry, I have to go film a movie, but the teacher.
Son-in-law. I mean, you know what? You got a hell of a resume for that era.
Yeah.
When I forgot son-in-law.
Pauly Eating Shore, a sandwich, introducing him to porn on your computer.
I remember too much
of this shit.
But my drama teacher was not having it. She didn't care. She was like, it doesn't matter. I don't care what movie you did. You need to do this role. And I was like, I can't.
You made the right choice.
Yeah, of course you did. Some jealous teacher no, I'm important.
Oh, yeah.
You're
not. Yeah, the drama teacher that never made it herself.
It's a gym teacher telling Peyton Manning, don't go fucking play. You have class.
Yeah, right. Real acting is in a school theater.
Hey,
she was pissed?
Yeah, and I don't think it made it better that I just kind of went, bye.
What's her name?
I don't
Do you have her address?
Hey, was Hollywood?
She's no longer with us either, man.
Exactly.
Oh, what the
her
hell?
And the dog got hit by the same train. Was Hollywood good to you? Because you know Corey Feldman tells all these stories about these creeps that were in Hollywood if you were a kid in Hollywood.
Yeah.
A lot of us didn't know. Did you have to encounter any of that, or did you avoid certain people, or how was that for you?
I mean, I think I encountered some of it, but I had a good base of friends that had pretty level heads, and you know, we had our fun in our 20s, but none of us, luckily.
Did you ever get your butthole creamed by glazed by MJ?
I didn't.
Oh.
Super direct question. Yeah. No, I mean, super
thanks.
Specific.
Yeah. Let me just check with my lawyer real quick before I answer that.
Glazed? No.
So
filled?
Yes.
I was lucky enough to kind of stay out of that environment pretty much.
Yeah, because you hear it now, you're like, fuck, man. Yeah. Like, that was awful.
What about being a kid like in the movies, like, you know, like Harry Potter, right? Daniel Radcliffe ended up hooking up when he was a kid, his first virgin loss of his virginity
with the director, right?
No, it was with one of the girls in the costume department.
Oh,
did you
really?
Ever like hit like an older lady?
Wow, how old was he?
Oh, he was a kid. He was like a teenage boy. Yeah, he was a teenage boy.
Was he 18 or was he like a young
No, he was younger than that. But that's great. 16 is the legal age in England, but I think he was 15 when he had sex with
With the non-working costume designer now.
So the charges maybe should be pressed. Yeah, that's still sounds illegal.
Yeah.
Oh, no, 100%.
Yeah, okay.
Again, I'm going to check with my lawyer before I answer this question, too. I guess I'm sure. I don't know.
Yeah, you did.
I was the chubby kid. So
right.
I didn't.
But
you
were famous, dude. It doesn't matter.
Did
what
you go to college?
You're famous.
I went to college for like a semester in LA and then stopped.
It's gotta be hard to go to college after you have you're doing films all of a sudden. It was like we had Jerry O'Connell yesterday talking about going to law school for a little. It's like, how do you settle in and go to class after such a?
That was difficult. That's kind of where I had the rough transition, and I decided not to do it because it was a little rough, you know, college in LA. Yeah. 18, 19.
It's like being a veteran, really, isn't it? The PTSD.
It's exactly like being a veteran.
Thank you for understanding my struggle. Yeah, and Jerry O'Connell.
Thank you for your service. I appreciate
you're
it.
You're welcome. I mean, if anyone knows, it's him, you know? But he grew up to be 6 foot. Yeah.
He looks different.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, it's probably not the best thing. But just the idea of quitting or slowing down acting to do something in a classroom is just. Yeah. Who the fuck? Duff McKagan went to business school. And became like got like a business degree.
Yeah, but I feel like
after Guns N' Roses.
Yeah, being in Guns N' Roses, doing something so normal probably is so different. But it's almost like its own little adventure. You know what I mean? Like living that lifestyle for so long, just doing normal people things is like, whoa, this
right.
is nuts.
You're no longer doing heroin and starting fires.
Exactly.
I guess so.
Exactly.
Unless you're working in finance, and then you continue to do heroin, right?
Patrick Renna, you can follow Patrick on Twitter, by the way, at Patrick Renna, R-E-N-N-A. You also have a podcast at YouReKillingMePod.com.
Yeah.
Which great. I love.
You're killing me. Yeah. I had to run with it, right?
I love it when people just
embrace
lean
it.
In. Yeah. Just lean. This is what's working.
Yeah.
Just lean in and enjoy it. And I'm
Give
sure
the
that.
People what they want.
And everywhere you go, people, I'm sure, love it. You got yeah. fans because of it. And I mean, talk about leaning in. You are the Grambassador.
Now, this is leaning in, my man.
For
yes.
National S'mores Day.
August 10th.
Did you even know National S'mores Day was upon us? It's this weekend. It's Saturday.
Do you even know what a s'more is?
I do know what a s'more is, yes.
I was hoping you'd say no. You could have said you're killing
yeah.
me.
Yeah.
Oh. That was the line. Yes, he was setting you up. Mike, do you know what a s'more is?
I have no idea. Never heard of one.
You're killing me, Mike.
He did it! Yeah!
See, I've heard it differently.
I bought it for you.
When I've been making love to a woman. And I'm like, do you like my dick? And she said, I wish there was more.
And then you can say, some more what?
Different. Your lack Different. Of girth is killing me.
No, your lack of girth is killing no one.
I didn't know there was a National S'mores Day myself until last year, August 10th. I found out for the first time.
And then did you reach out to the s'mores people and say, if you guys are going to be doing this, I need to be involved?
You know, this year, World Mark by Wyndham asked me to do it because they're giving away s'mores kits at their locations. And I know, it's pretty great. So, and you know, getting families together, and what better way to do that than roasting a marshmallow over a fire?
Mm-hmm. It is amazing.
It's
so if
nice.
People
don't say anything naughty from that.
I'm not saying anything.
I saw where you were about.
Dude, I've never felt more British this entire conversation. I have no idea what anything you guys
you,
are doing.
You don't know what a s'more is?
S'mores? What is this film?
You.
Who's killing who?
You're
I don't understand
your mind.
Anything.
We interviewed Wesley Snipes together.
Yeah.
He is bullshit compared to this. I am shivering with excitement.
Oh, yeah. You were so excited for Wesley. So you've been in here with me for Wesley Snipes. You've been in here with me for Ice Cube.
Marsha Brady.
Oh
my
gosh.
She wanted a piece.
She did.
Yeah, she did.
And now that we have Patrick Renna in here,
this is
the
way
this
better.
Is this is the one.
Wow. Yeah.
Wait, how do you describe Jeff is British? What is s'mores is?
He's asking s'more what?
Yeah, s'more.
Just look behind you.
Oh no, I saw it. Yeah, graham crackers.
Oh, those are
marshmallow.
Wait. I'm basically the American Harry Potter. That's all you need. Just, you're good.
You take it. The graham.
Yeah.
Right.
You stick
the graham cracker. And when you say Graham, what you really mean is Graham, right?
Graham.
Yeah.
Graham. Welcome.
My dad's name, you know, Graham. Right.
Assimilate. Okay. Welcome. Okay. Graham.
Okay. And then you take out
place
some letters.
Place the chocolate.
Oh, sorry.
No. That's
aluminium.
Different.
Sorry. Okay.
Yeah. I don't know what that is that you just said. Sure. You place the chocolate.
I think it's aluminum, but it's
oh,
like,
that makes sense the way you say it. Yeah. On the Graham.
Chocolate goes on there.
You toast the mellow.
Yeah, roast the mellow.
Roast the mellow.
Yeah, close enough. Yeah.
Marshmallow. Marshmallow.
Yes, yes. Place the, I mean, could you?
You stick the mellow on the chocolate.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
When the mellow's flaming.
Wait, say it slower and sexier.
When the mellow's flaming, you stick it on the chocolate.
Okay.
Can't do this.
Mike's losing his mind over there right now.
I love
that. This is literally, this is a whole scene from the movie The Sandlot. That he was the star of. He's explaining s'mores
again,
in.
I've never seen
Mike
the Sandlot.
Is as excited
I'm so embarrassed.
If I was here when Malcolm McDowell was tying up a woman and slapping her.
I'm not going to lie. When you walked in, I thought you might have been the guy from you know, The Lost Boys. The oh, no. Who's
Which
the Chunk? No. The one, the Chunk. What is it?
From Goonies.
From Goonies.
Goonies. Yeah.
That's not cool.
That's not
cool.
Why is that not cool?
It's just not a cool thing to say.
Because he did the Truffle Shuffle.
That's not. I'm
but
sorry.
He was a
he's
kid.
Not
he was
can
a,
I tell you he's not usually here?
Yeah.
We didn't know you were coming in. I wouldn't have allowed Jeff.
I like
Jeff
how en masse you all hate me. I didn't realize.
I mean, that's so insulting. If I said, Jeff, if I said to you right now, Oh, Jeff, weren't you that kid in the Goonies, the Truffle Shuffle kid? Yeah. Wouldn't you be like, the I'd fuck? Like,
is okay. that the Goonies kid?
He's a huge entertainment lawyer yeah, now, right? Yeah.
Oh, is he? Oh,
with great. A jawline. Look at him.
I know, jeez.
Oh, that's him as a lawyer. Okay.
Yeah.
I actually watched the Goonies on the flight over. It still holds up,
Isn't
too.
Isn't it amazing?
So good. That was my Sandlot.
You still live in L.A.?
I do, yeah.
You do, okay.
So have you guys filmed the Sandlot series for Disney Plus?
Not yet. They kind of just announced it last year. We all went in and met with them. They told us some of the storylines and saw if we were interested.
What is the concept behind it? Are you guys have kids that are doing it, or what's the?
Yeah, I think generally that's the idea, and I think the Sandlot's involved in it. And what they kind of explained, I don't think I can probably say too much
sure.
You know. Hoping I still can be in it, you know. Thanks, No, but I think it has ties to that, and it, you know, all the guys are into doing it, and the kind of concepts they had were fun, and I have a lot of stuff with the Squints character, which is cool because Chauncey, who plays Squints, is the guy that I've sort of still hung out with over the years.
He was great in the Eminem video,
unbelievable, and I had him on the podcast, and we talked about it. A lot of people were wondering if it was him or Logic because he did so good. It was him the whole video.
Want more Jim and Sam? Catch up with full episodes and interviews from celebrity guests anytime on demand using the SiriusXM app.